He gets 10 federal holidays, 13 sick days, and 20 vacation days per year. All of these numbers come from the watchdog group called Open the Books. Yes, please. Granted, many of these highly paid government workers have professional qualifications. Got it. And they work in very stressful situations. Got that too. But it grates, doesn't it? How do you feel when you have to ask permission to expand your business from someone who makes more than you do and doesn't like business to begin with? How do you feel when you see highly paid bureaucrats engaging in an apparent conspiracy to support Hillary Clinton and trash candidate Trump? Or IRS employees beating up President Obama's political opponents? Yes, it grates, it annoys, because it is essentially un-American. This country was not built by pampered, highly paid government workers. Yes, they played a part. But the days of ever-expanding government came to an end, I think, on November the 8th, 2016. It may have come to an end earlier, if much, our bureaucrat masters act. The third hour of Varney & Company is about to begin. I'll repeat that, 30,000 federal workers making more than any U.S. state governor. Come on in, Herb London, president of the London Center for Policy Research. Was I a little over the top there?
I don't think so. I think that it turns out that the swamp is a very useful way of generating prosperity for members of the government bureaucracy. I think that it is truly outrageous that we have these people in government who are earning that much money. I understand there's a need for bureaucracy, but what we've seen is a kind of dramatic increase in the number of bureaucrats working in Washington, D.C., in part because this becomes a way of extending the role of government. And for Obama, it was a very useful tactic.
You know, I didn't mention this in the editorial, but the five richest counties in the United States of America are, I believe, all suburbs of Washington, D.C., and house these well-paid federal bureaucrats.
Oh, well, it's understandable. I mean, if you're living in Potomac and you're a government employee, obviously you can afford to live there. I mean, the average person can certainly not do so.
It just makes you angry.
Per capita, the Iron Triangle and the Potomac neighborhoods and the D.C. neighborhoods make more than Silicon Valley. I mean, what does that say about the skewed reality of the United States? One in five federal workers make six figures. One in five federal workers make six
what?
Figures.
One
and
in
they,
five?
Yes, they make, there's 406,000.
That's right, 20%.
Make six figures. So, you know, what are they doing there? And by the way, we have to say, and this is a fact, a lot of government workers are Democrats. A lot of them work in a union. Many of them work at home, because working on union duties. They telework. And who launched that? That was President Obama. Said you could work from home if you are a federal employee.
You know, Lizzie, I think you buttoned that up very nicely.
Yeah.
I wasn't aware of those numbers, but that was good stuff. Thanks, Lizzie.